While the Buddha was residing at the Chetavana temple, he once told a story about the allure of a coarse girl. A mother and her daughter lived together in the city of Sawati. Although the daughter turned 16, no men came to call upon her.
"My daughter is of marrying age, yet no man seems to want her. I know. Those Sakyans who became ascetics all come from royal families. If I can get one of them to renounce the holy life, my daughter will have someone to take care of her. I will use her as bait."
At that same time, there was a young man from a good family who had decided to dedicate himself to the religion and became a Buddhist monk. However, after he ordained, he was reluctant to work or practice, and devoted himself to gaining pleasure for himself. One day, the monks went on their usual bintaba, or alms rounds. The scheming mother had prepared rice and other delicacies, and waited in front of her house. She scanned the monks and searched for someone who might be tempted by her offerings. At last, a man approached, and she noticed he had fresh, clean, and expensive robes, a fancy alms bowl, and tanned skin. The scheming mother had found her prey.
"Daughter, we found him. See that monk over there? The one with the nice robes and shiny bowl? He's our target."
As the indulgent monk arrived, the daughter offered him the delicacies. After he received the food, she invited him to accept a full meal at her house. Tempted by the allure of good food, the monk accepted and went inside their house. The young girl sat an appropriate distance away and spoke with reverence and respect.
"Holy sir, honorable brother, we respectfully offer these foods to you. If they're not to your liking, please inform us so that we can provide that which would make you happy."
After a pleasing meal, the monk got up to leave. The young girl saw him to the door.
"Most honorable brother, would you be so kind as to come back here tomorrow, so that we can offer you better food? It is our honor to serve you and make you happy."
The monk felt that something was not quite right, but was tempted by the allure of the food and the young girl's charms. The next day, the young girl wore more revealing clothing and sat a little closer when offering the food. The closer she sat to the monk, the more uncomfortable he became. On one hand, he knew it was wrong, but on the other, he was tempted to follow his desires. Then, the mother and daughter feigned a private conversation and made sure that it was loud enough for the monk to overhear.
"Daughter, make a lot of merit. Maybe then you will find a husband. You are so young, pure, and any man would be lucky to have you as a wife. I don't understand why you're still single."
"I don't know either, mother. Maybe the fates are waiting for me to find my soulmate. Once I do, I will dedicate my life to him and do anything he wants or needs. I will serve him completely and make him so happy. Who knows? Maybe he'll come for me soon."
The young monk heard this
and began feeling hot all over. When he returned to his kuti, or hut, he could not sleep. He kept replaying what he overheard. He kept imagining how wonderful it would be to have that young girl take care of him and please him. He knew it was wrong and detrimental to his life as a monk, but his desires overtook him like an avalanche. Even with his eyes open, he could see everything about the young girl. He imagined her in front of him and thought inappropriate thoughts. He was unable to focus and often stared off into the distance, thinking of her. Finally, the young monk was fully taken over by passion and went to his elder and said, "I can no longer stay a monk. I am discontented."
"What is it that has made you discontented?"
"Teacher, it is a girl." The monk's teacher took him to go see the Buddha. The Buddha asked him, "Monk, your teacher says you are discontented and wish to disrobe. Is this true?"
"Yes, my lord."
"What has led you to become discontented?"
"A coarse girl. I can't get her out of my mind, and I wish to make her my wife and be with her."
"In the past, when you were living in the forest, this same girl was a hindrance to your quest for holiness and did you great harm. Now, in this life, you are discontented with your holy life again, for her?"
"My lord, you can see that which I cannot. Please tell me how it was in the past."
At his request, the Buddha told a story of the past. In the past, when Brahmadatta was king in Benares, the Bodhisat was born into a Brahmin family of great wealth. He had a son with his wife. Unfortunately, she died shortly after giving birth to their son. The Bodhisat thought,
"Just like my wife, death is waiting for me. What good is worldly life? I will become an ascetic."
And so, the Brahmin and his son went to the Himalayas and became ascetics. At that time, there was a group of bandits raiding the countryside. After they robbed a village, along with all the loot, they would also take prisoners. Amongst them was a beautiful but cunning woman. She thought,
"These men, they will take us home and make us slaves. They will do unspeakable things to me. I must find some way to escape."
So, she said to one of the leaders of the bandits, "My lord, I wish to spend some private time with you. Is there somewhere we can go for some privacy? I promise not to disappoint."
"Ha! Yes, that sounds like a splendid idea. I was thinking the same thing. Come with me. I know where to go."
"But my lord, I can't walk with my hands tied. Could you do something about it?"
Thinking dirty thoughts, the bandit did not suspect a thing. He untied the woman's bonds. Then, he led her into the forest. When they were alone, the woman waited for an opportunity and dropped a large rock on the bandit's head. Then, she ran away. As she made her way through the forest, she came upon a young man meditating. She thought,
Perfect. This young man will be my new protector and provider. It'll be easy to bring him under my power. He can't resist a woman like me.
She came crashing out of the woods and dove into his arms, saying,
"Save me! Help me!"
She had completely surprised the young man, and he reacted instinctively. All he could do was catch her. When he looked upon her, all he could see was her beauty.
"Sir, I need you to protect me. I am alone. I have no husband. I was taken prisoner by bandits. I'm so scared. I can't be alone. Please, sir, I need you."
The young man, having no experience with women, consoled her. Eventually, she was able to corrupt his virtue. The coarse woman then thought,
"I now have this young, inexperienced boy under my power. He will take care of me from now on."
"My love, why should we dwell in this forest? Let us go to the village and make a life for ourselves.
There, it will be much easier to enjoy all types of passion together."
"I'm happy to go with you, but what about my father?
He's out in the woods looking for wild fruits. Let's wait for him to return, and then we can go."
The girl thought,
"This young innocent boy knows nothing, but his father is probably wise. If I stay here, he will know what I did, and beat me and chase me away. But if I leave first, the boy may still follow."
And so she said,
"My love, I will go first.
Then, after you meet your father, follow me."
After he finished collecting, the ascetic headed back. On the way, he observed footprints. He thought,
"Those are the footprints of a woman. Alas, my son's virtue must be lost."
"My son, no wood has been chopped. No water has been gathered. No fire has been kindled. Why do you lie around?"
"Father, I've decided I can no longer live in the forest. I will go to the village and make my way. Please teach me the customs of village life so that I know what to do."
"Son, it is not as easy as you think. Nothing in this world is. Everything has two sides, a desirable and an undesirable side. You are only thinking of the desirable side. Therefore, you are blinding yourself to the truth."
"Father, what do you mean?"
"Listen closely, and I will tell you the customs of the country. My son, you must beware of cliffs, mud, poison, and snakes."
"Huh? What do you mean, father?"
"There is liquor in the cities, my son. Some men call it wine. It is fragrant, delicious, cheap, and full of flavor. However, Narada, this liquor is poison for holy men. It causes one to lose their wits and sensibility. You will loosen your tongue, your morals, and your virtues. This poison leads to violence, evil, and bad karma. There are women in these cities. Women that can set your wits whirling around. They catch young hearts, just as hurricanes catch cotton from the ground. For the sake of a woman, a good man may turn evil. A good man may kill, steal, and commit violence for the sake of a woman. A good man may turn his back on his friends and family for the sake of a woman. This is the cliff I mentioned.
In these cities, you might gain many high honors, respect, and fame. However, if you subject yourself to praise and compliments, you will also open yourself up to criticism and other unwanted words. This is the mud I spoke of.
In the cities, there are many powerful people. Great monarchs, nobles, and wealthy men all come with retinues. You might find yourself joining one of these retinues. But it is not safe to live under those with power. This power often corrupts, and many abuse it. The ones who suffer the most are the ones that live under their feet. These are the snakes that I spoke of. Living in the city is not all pleasure and comfort. In order to survive, you must earn a living. To earn a living, you must work. For most, work involves labor. You trade your labor for money. Often, the money you receive is barely enough to survive on. After a long day of work, you are usually exhausted and hungry.
As his father went on talking and talking, the young boy began to see the truth.
Father, enough! I don't want to go anymore. City life sounds horrible.
His father taught him to develop kindness and compassion, and to strictly adhere to morality and virtue. The son followed his father's instructions, and they lived as hermits for the rest of their lives. After their deaths, they entered the Brahma world. The Buddha then concluded the Jataka by saying,
"The young woman who took the young man's virtue was reborn as the coarse girl. The young ascetic's son was reborn as the discontented monk. The father was none other than I."
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project, Culla-Narada Jataka.